Hey guys, it's Steve from Rhinomax Campus here, and today we're at the beautiful Noosa North Shore Beach to show you the Renegade. So, a great little camper for towing up the beach as it follows in the tracks of your car, tows very, very easily, just like a camper trailer. It's agile and can get up into all those spots which you might not be able to get with the bigger models. So, first things first, let's take you through how easy this thing is to set up. One of the great benefits of a Rhinomax camper is you can actually leave your car hooked up and get into the back of it while the camper's on it. Now, we do this by positioning the hitch sunken down into the actual drawbar here, so there's no kind of restriction. So as you can see, I can open the back of the cruiser, no problem at all, drop the tailgate. So if you've got a Prado or a Ute or anything like that, you know what? Easy to get into the back of them with no restrictions. And that's pretty handy if you want to camp overnight somewhere and let's say you don't want to unhitch or anything. You know what? Just leave it on and away you go. The awning on these things winds out pretty simply. Now, I'll get my winding handle out from in the front storage compartment, and then it's just a case of winding it out. Again, when you're on a windier place like the beach, always peg the awning or rope it down. So the awning winds out halfway, and then I can drop my legs. Just like so, very, very easy. And then winding it out the rest of the way. Goes out round about 2.5 meters. That's it. So now, just straighten it up. That's it. We're pretty much set up now for a great weekend's worth of beach camping. Now, the star of the show of Rhinomax campers is the kitchens. And although I'm biased, because I think they're great, they really are easy to set up and quick and very functional. So let's have a look. Basically, we just start opening drops down. This also creates a great windbreak for if there's wind like we are on the beach here from coming underneath. Now, the kitchen, it just slides out. The extended workbench flaps over, and then this reveals our storage areas. So we've got two large storage drawers above the kitchen. As you can see, you can get plenty of plates, cheese boards, that kind of stuff in them. They just go back in. I've got here a three burner stove. Now, we use the three burners rather than four. That gives you one large burner for frying pans and that, and then two smaller burners. Electronic ignition. The grill comes off. Now that's really easy to clean, so exceptionally good for that. And it just clips straight back on, like so. And that was even a bloke doing it. Then this reveals a huge sort of cutlery utensil drawer. And then underneath your sink, you've got a space for your dishcloths, washing up liquids, that kind of thing. Not only that, the tap is great. We can flip it over, turn it, and now I can fill a kettle or a water bottle, you know, or whatever big sort of container that I've actually got. Now, you may think that's all, but it's not. Our fridge. So that just slides out on a slide. You get, I think it's about either 70 or 69 litres, the fridges. Now, as you can see, everything is around where you actually want to be. So now I'm set up, I'm literally ready for cooking up a storm. Okay, now that we've got the outside set up, let me show you how easy it is to pop the roof and set up the inside. So we've got two clips on the back. Yeah, and then I pull the step out, open the door. Now I'm just going to go inside and push the roof up. Now the roof pushes up on two gas struts, so very, very easy. That's it. I'm ready for my tea. I'm ready for my bed. And in between, a few beers. There's nothing better when you're out camping than a great shower. And this is one of the best. Let me show you how quick and easy this is to set up. Just undo the clips. Voila! It's easy, just four clips at the back to undo. Four at the front. That's it. Now, seeing as we're actually on the beach and it's got a little bit of a breeze, I'm going to put four pegs in the shower tent as well. But essentially, how good is that? Large shower, big enough for two. Great, when you come off from the surf, you want to just wash down. You know what? Easy, simple, good. That's Rhinomax. Well, guys, we've showed you the other side where the kitchen is and everything else. Now let's have a look at what storage this camper has. And I think once you see it, you'll agree there's a huge amount of storage for the size of camper that we've actually got here. Your gas bottles just sit in there. 2 4-kilo gas bottles in their own secure box. Here, we've got a large storage compartment where, you know, you can put tent poles, fishing rods, any of that sort of stuff. On the top here, we do lots of options. Boat loader mounts, bike carriers, all of that. The cargo basket, though, it has to be said, is a great option. Great for carrying firewood, dirty tarps, you know, all that sort of stuff. Even though you have a fridge in the other side of this box, if we open it, it's a tunnel boot box. And, you know, there's still about 2/3 of the box empty, what you can utilize for large storage tubs. You want to carry a generator, you know, anything like that. Now, a lot of people ask, where do you carry your camp chairs and tables, the bigger stuff? Watch this. This is huge. You know, so we've got a great area in there. Tables, chairs, you know, all of that sort of stuff. This is where the battery and the electrics are housed. So our lithium power plant's in here. And at the back, our port-a-loo can be taken out and used in the ensuite, or alternatively, you can use it inside by lifting the seat up inside. I think you'd agree, a huge amount of space for a camper that's very, very small. Also on the driver's side, we've got our 240 power inlet. So that's if you want to plug into a caravan site or campsite main power, that plugs straight in here. We've got a water pressure reducer, so that reduces mains water pressure to a safe pressure for all the fittings with inside the camper. We've got our inlet for the tank, so the water filler cap. And down here, we also have our external water draw or creek draw facility. So I can put a hose into there and I can drop it into a jerry can, a bucket, a river, a creek. If it was long enough, probably the sea. All Rhinomax campers have been designed for off-grid travel and come with great power systems. The Renegade is no exception. As standard, we've got 400 watts of solar on the roof. That can be increased if you so wish. We've also got remote solar connection points, so you can plug in a portable set of panels or, like we have here, a solar blanket. Now that then runs into a minimum of 200 amps of lithium, which this comes standard with. We also do various power systems to control air conditioners, etc. We can go 600, 800 amps depending on what your actual requirements are. But the standard charging system in here is boosted up to 40 amp twin chargers. So a 40 amp DC and a 40 amp AC charger. On top of that, there's an Anderson connection on here, which will connect to the back of your car, so you can also charge the camper while you're actually traveling. So all round, we're taking charge from every source we can get to extend your stays out on the actual grid. I'm inside the Renegade now, and even though the Renegade only is a 12-foot camper, you'd be amazed at what we've packed into here and the actual amount of space. So it's got two modes. It's got a nighttime mode and a daytime mode. We're currently in the nighttime mode. So basically that is with the bed down. So I've still got lots of room to sit here, and I've got a full queen size bed area here. High ceilings, so no, there's no claustrophobia or anything in here, and I can still access the full kitchen at the back. Now, if I want to move out of the nighttime mode to the daytime mode, it's very, very simple. All I have to do is raise the bed. Now, the bed raises on gas struts, so really, really easy. Lift the table. And now I'm in the daytime mode. So I've got a great lounge area here where we can sit, you know, three, four people, no problem at all. I've got a big space underneath the bed there. The table can swivel out the way, so you can take it out, you can leave it in, you can swivel it, you can do what you want with it. Underneath the bed, we've also got two large storage drawers. So they're great for your clothing and stuff like that, you know, quite a decent size. And at the back, as I said, we've still got the full size kitchen here. It has a large storage compartment in the corner here. And then we also have a huge bank of drawers. So there's no shortage of space in the Renegade at all. And that's on the inside, never mind what you've got outside. On your kitchen bench here, we've got a sunken sink. We've got a mixer tap that's connected to hot and cold water. We've got a Fusion stereo system, and we've got our speakers at the back, 240 power points, 12 volt power points, USB points, you know, all of that's in here. This one's also got the options of the fan and the TV. So, you know, it can be as elaborate as you want inside, but these really are a great camper and lots of space. Rhinomax campers now all come with the new digital Rhinomax command centers. So your camper can be controlled digitally by this screen here, or we can log into our phone and just control everything by the phone. Now, to give you a bit of an idea of that, these have been designed like a smartphone. So if I want to turn lights on or off, say for instance, I'll just click the light button, and then my cabin lights, I'll just turn them off. And as you can see, they're now going off. I'll just flick them back on, and they're back on. We've also got full battery monitoring in here. So it'll tell you what life's in your battery, how many hours you've got left, what your charge is going to be, how much solar you're putting in, all of that. Water is the same. We've got complete water tank sensors in there, so you can tell what's in your tanks and everything else. There's a lot of other smart gizmos in this stuff as well. There's smart modes, camping mode, towing mode, storage mode. If you go onto our website, you can learn quite a bit more about that. Now, the thing with digital technology is it's absolutely fantastic. But if you get any issues with the digital technology, we've also got a lot of built-in redundancy. So there's also a full set of manual controls. So say, for instance, I want to use just the ordinary standard button. I can switch the camper's lights off with the ordinary button. And also, there's a full range of other functions that we can do that. So we've tried to cover both bases, so there's no way you can be stuck if you're off the grid. I'll tell you what, this is one of the most advanced and best systems that you're likely to see. Worth coming to have a look at. Well, that's a wrap up of the Renegade and our run through. So thanks for joining us for that. I hope you got something out of it. If you've got any questions, queries, whatever, just give our office a ring and we'll be happy to help you. So that's us for now. So we'll see you next time.